We're at the Amway Center, where the crowd is on their feet already. And we've been waiting for this day for a long time. It's opening day in the NBA. Thanks, everyone, for joining us here in the start of a new season. This is Kevin Harlan, and by my side, Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. From the sideline, Hall of Famer David Aldridge. This crowd is really ready to roar in this Eastern Conference matchup for the Magic. And before we get underway here, let's send it over to Hall of Famer David Aldridge, who was able to talk with Steve Clifford.
Well, guys, he told me that today is all about setting the tone for the rest of the season series with this team. He said they're going to be a tough opponent for us every time we see them, and we've got to let them know right now, today, that we're going to be just as tough for them. We'll find out, indeed, if they can set the right tone, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And in these early stages, Chris, of the season, how quickly do you start to get a sense of where your team stands and how good they can be or how bad they might be?
I would say that first 20 games is a really good kind of litmus test. Gives you a pretty good gauge to see where your team is. You're going to get to play against teams from both conferences. You have some really good teams and bad teams in that mix. So you kind of see how you play in all situations. Those first 20 games, you establish who you are.
Here we go.
And it's going to be the Magic off the tip. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. And Charlotte looking at who they've got. Walker and Monk are the guard tandem. Batum's out there with Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And it's Howard in at the five down low. And Walker kicks to Monk. Here's Howard. Great D that time from Vucevic.
Does well to burrow his way into the post, but loses his touch on the finish.
Fournier in the corner. Pass to Isaac. Basket is good, and he'll get a chance for one more at the free throw line.
How about the concentration on that? Isaac able to absorb the contact and still finish with a difficult shot. And Jonathan Isaac, a 6'11 small forward out of Florida State, you know, we're seeing more and more players like this with the length of a center and the guard skills. You know, you think of KD, of Brandon Ingram, and now Isaac.
That's good from Isaac. And the story for Jonathan Isaac, as a sophomore in high school, Greg, he stood 6'3" and played guard. He hit a growth spurt, as you can see.
Yeah, and it makes a difference. I think what I noticed most is that he's retained not just the perimeter skill, but also the fluidity. I mean, he's light on his feet and really moves well. Remember, there was another guy that was a point guard and had a nice growth spurt. I think his name was Anthony Davis.
And it's Gordon missing.
The movement and the shot selection are good there, but you can't hit them all.
Outside, Walker. There's a screen. Outside, Batum. That three off the mark.
He finds a major hole in the D beyond the arc. He still can't cash in on it.
From deep, the Magic again can't hit. Charlotte's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Walker the pass to Monk. Back to Walker. Lets it go with a three. Fournier pulls it down. Magic have gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Here's Isaac. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket. Isaac's got five now.
Yeah, I tell you what, Isaac really rebounds well for his position. Takes advantage of that length and his reach to track down rebounds.
Now, here's Howard. That doesn't fall either. He's missed his first two shots tonight.
Really just struggling here in the first few minutes. Five attempts with only one falling.
Payton dishes to Gordon. Shot from 12. That one off the back iron and out.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
From deep, Walker. Again, the miss by Walker.
Oh, man, you can't get much better look from three-point range than that one. That just wasn't in rhythm.
Gordon a screen. Here's Isaac, defended by Batum. Shot clock at 6. Pass to Vucevic. From 15 feet away, and the shot goes down. Vucevic has got his second basket of the game.
Working the in-between area, the kind of look that can get you into a rhythm early.
Yeah, I think he was surprised. He was so open. I mean, that's just a defensive breakdown.
So it's Orlando now, after the basket by Charlotte. Outside Gordon at the elbow, Vucevic. Payton against Batum. Right at the free throw line. It's rebounded by Charlotte. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
No good that time. And Orlando the other way now. And this matchup with the Hornets, it's their first game of the NBA's regular season.
And going back to last season, they really struggled for wins. And even against a team like this with comparable talent, they didn't manage one win in the season series.
Now here's Payton. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. A timely screen gave him a step, and he took it all the way.
And they've done the job on the offensive glass.
Kid Gilchrist, a screen on Payton. And Batum kicks to Howard. It's good. It's his second basket. He's shooting 2 for 4.
Outstanding presence of mind. Howard is as dependable as he gets near the rim.
Walker against Payton. Gordon a screen. Here's Isaac. He's got 5. It's Fournier on the wing. Over Monk. And he gets that one to go off the front iron. Fournier's got his first 2 points.
Yeah, off to a strong start here early. 6 points off second chance buckets.
Walker the pass to Monk. With some arc. And it's good on the way in. Monk's got his second basket of the night.
And how committed is Monk there on the attack to the rim? When he puts it on the deck, he's looking to take it all the way.
Here's Isaac. Connects from 3-point range. Hornets trail by 7.
And since Dwight Howard back in 2012, the rebuild effort just has languished here in Orlando, unable really to draft any superstar talent. And last season, trades for veteran talent didn't really move the needle either.
Out of bounds, Orlando takes possession.
And a moment to see numbers for Nicholas Batum. Last year, getting it done. Averaged about 15 points a game, 6 assists and 6 rebounds. And he has been passing the ball like a virtuoso. That's what really stands out about these recent performances.
Hey, every symphony needs a conductor. He unifies his teammates, sets the tempo, and they make some sweet, sweet moves.
Now Gordon, after the missed 3 from Malik Monk. 4 on the clock. Vucevic setting the pick for Fournier. Over Howard. Monk grabs the board.
He's still looking to get into a groove this quarter.
Outside Batum. Howard setting the pick for Batum. And it comes off the front of the rim.
Just doing the job on the backboard.
Pass to Isaac. Beyond the arc. He can't get that one to fall. And Charlotte will go the other way with it. 3-on-3. Al Fournier shoots from 14. Dwight Howard grabs the board.
Nothing seems to be going down for him today.
Now, here's Monk. He's guarded by Fournier. The dish to Monk. Shoots over Fournier. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. 7 points for Malik Monk.
It's an encouraging sign to see Monk working off those pin downs. An effective shooter when he gets any sort of daylight.
It's stolen by Monk. By himself. And then Monk with the dunk.
And that's such good work to make this a one possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
And the replay is courtesy of Under Armour. Unleash chaos. It was a great sequence from the steal all the way to the finish at the other end. Here's Isaac. He's got eight. Gordon up on top. He dishes it to Fournier. Six to shoot. The Magic again can't hit. Hornets trail by three. Here's the teardrop, and it's blocked by Gordon. Payton with the ball. Now here's Fournier. Pass to Isaac. Traps in the tray. Isaac's got 11 points.
He's taking over the game. Their lead's going to get even bigger if he keeps this up.
Charlotte's gone 1-5 from downtown in the first quarter. Points out there have been hard to come by. Howard with a screen on Payton. Walker dishes to Howard. Orlando grabs the miss. Vucevic has got four rebounds now tonight. Fournier gets a wide open look, but they'll get another chance. Payton kicks to Gordon. Feeds to Vucevic over Howard. Another miss by Vucevic. Hornets trail by six. And here is Monk. He's got nine. It's hauled in by Gordon. Gordon's got his fourth rebound in this one. Here's Isaac. And Chris, when you played, you were known as a guy your size who could rip and run, take it coast to coast. You look around the league now, who are some of the best big men ball handlers?
Oh, you love it. If you get that board, you got to be able to take it, speed up the offense. We've seen Draymond just have a field day doing it with all the players on his team that could knock it down and score. Blake Griffin, Anthony Davis. We've even seen Paul Millsap and Julius Randle do it a little bit. So I love the fact that if you can get that board and push it, it makes it easier because you don't have to look for the outlet. You can actually find that point guard, that two guard in transition, and let them score and you be the facilitator.
And he knocks down the first one. And last season, Greg, one big issue for the Hornets was their bench.
And Charlotte tried their best to address that issue this past offseason. And it just goes to show that you need to have a complete roster to compete. A lot of games were given away by the Hornets last year by losing ground when the starters left the court.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
And the overall skill set that Isaac possesses really off the charts. A big man who can run the floor, but also with that wingspan can defend the rim.
Kaminsky inside. Charlotte again missing.
And they've come out with a take-no-prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
No good from Ross. Hornets trail by eight. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Well, during his career, Williams has been up and down shooting the three, but you at least got to crowd his airspace, not let him get a free look when he's firing.
And it's the Magic with the ball, following the three by Charlotte. Biombo with it, and Zeller picks him up defensively.
Come get it.
Here's Azania. Fires for three. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Okay, we got a nice little back and forth going here.
And I love it, Greg. Both sides inflicting damage from the perimeter.
Offensive rebound. Shot by Zeller, no good. Last outing for Charlotte, they won that game against Dallas. Here's Azania, covered by Lamb. Azania's shot is off. Hornets trail by eight. From 13, Williams. It's good. It's his second basket. He's shooting two for four.
Well, over time, I would say, Williams has morphed into a reliable small/power forward, especially in his rebound.
Now, here's Biombo. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. And a wide open look for Lamb. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. Now it's just a three-point Magic lead. Orlando's gone 3-7 from three-point range in the first quarter. Payton against Walker. Pass to Isaac. Shoots the three. Rebounded by Kaminsky.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Charlotte moving the ball around. Here's Zeller. Biombo with the block. Fast break. Here come the Magic. Ross is running. Isaac. Rebounded by Kaminsky. Hornets trail by three. 24 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Ross against Williams. From deep. Walker. Goes back up. And it's finished off inside by Kaminsky. Kaminsky's got his first points of the game.
He's so intelligent around the rim. Kaminsky found a way to own that possession.
Pass to Isaac. They can't stop the run with that one. Back right after this. And Dwight Howard, a lightning rod figure around the league, subject to a lot of criticism, but he says he takes comfort in playing the game he still loves.
Basketball, this is my passion. You know, on the court, it's my sanctuary. You know, I want to have fun. The reason I play is to win championships, and I take this game very seriously.
It's an interesting concept that Dwight has to take something very seriously in order to have fun. He does say he has a burning passion to win a championship. He's been in the finals, and this is a guy that's got still a lot to shoot for, he feels, in his career.
It's a great point, Kevin. And the challenge for Dwight is how to balance how serious he is and how passionate he is with having that fun on the court that he's after.
And we got a close game here as we get back to the second quarter. And from what we've seen from Orlando, what do you guys see?
I tell you what, that first quarter, you can see the game plan is a commitment to offensive rebound.
Oh, yeah, this is how they squeezed out extra possessions and captured the early lead.
So on the floor for Charlotte to start this second quarter. Down low, it's Kaminsky and Zeller. Kemba Walker is out there with Jeremy Lamb, and it's Williams at the small forward position. Now here's Williams. He kicks to Kaminsky, back to Williams. Charlotte needs to get a shot up. And here's Walker outside. But they recover it. Here in the second quarter with a little over a minute gone. And Zeller kicks to Williams. And it's Williams again missing. Orlando leading. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, the Orlando Magic do have a stacked front court. They've got plenty of size. Head coach Frank Vogel said, in today's small ball NBA, we think we can beat the heck out of teams in the paint. But shooting has been a hindrance, and he conceded we might have to win some games, 68-65. Kevin?
Going against the grain, DA. Thank you. I just want to preface this by saying Kemba Walker had an incredible year last season, and he showed why he is among the elite point guards in the NBA. Chris, with that being said, one thing you can't help but chuckle
gentlemen?
About was his egregious premature celebration that he had on a missed three-pointer.
Yeah, Kevin, we all remember that. When you put a shot up, turn around, and do the nice shimmy while your team is busy rebounding your miss, yeah, it sticks with you. I love Kemba, but that was one of the bigger bloopers of the season.
Now here's Payton. Kicks it to Biombo. Shot from 12. Payton can't get that one to fall. Charlotte in the lead. Lamb with the ball. Now Payton defending. Over in the corner, Williams. And Zeller kicks to Lamb. Lamb sets a screen for Walker. Passes it to Lamb. The feed to Williams. Jacks up a three. Hornets keep it alive. Now Lamb. Outside, Walker. Zeller up top, covered by Biombo. And he gets the bucket. Now it's a 3-point Charlotte lead.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Payton kicks to Ross. Back to Payton. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Dishes it to Lamb. He feeds it to Walker. Williams passes to Kaminsky. Outside Williams. To the inside. And Zeller kicks to Kaminsky. Off target with his three. Orlando, they've gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Payton dishes to Simmons. And there's the pass to Hazania. Back to Simmons. Pass to Hazania. Takes a three. Rebounded by Kaminsky. Kaminsky's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. Williams passes to Zeller. Over Payton. And there's Zeller. That's good on the assist from Marvin Williams. Zeller's got the lead up to 3 now for the Hornets. Ross against Zeller. From 11 feet away. Ross, that's good.
Great awareness. No reason to take it inside there against the taller man.
Well, he created a little separation from that mid-range. Just a good shot for him in that situation.
Now here's Kaminsky. Out to the right wing. And stolen by Payton. Pass break. Here come the Magic. In the corner, Simmons with it. Chance there to take the lead. Missing. For Charlotte, they've gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Walker with a clean look. Shot clock reset for Charlotte. Right wing. Here's Zeller. Orlando grabs the miss.
Well, that's giving him too much space from mid-range. It doesn't hurt him there, but they can't keep doing that.
Payton kicks to Ross. Simmons, a screen on Zeller. Out to Payton. 6 on the shot clock. Simmons sets a screen for Payton. Let's a floater go. Excellent D there from Williams. Charlotte shooting is definitely lagging at the moment. They're just 30% in the second quarter. The dish now to Kaminsky. And that's out of bounds. Charlotte will retain possession. And a look now at the 4 areas where shots can come from. The paint, mid-range, and shots from deep all broken down for Charlotte.
And they've pretty much ignored the corner 3 tonight. It's a useful shot to have. It really forces the D out wide and opens things up in the middle.
Lamb with the ball. Picked by Zeller. Payton against Walker. He dishes it to Zeller. Shot clock at 5. Shoots from 8.
He's trying to help him add to this lead, but he just can't find his touch.
Outside, Simmons. Feeds it to Biombo. There's the pick. Out to the right wing. Payton against Walker. Goes up the baseline. Bounces high off the rim and drops. 6 points for Elfrid Payton.
And looking at this Charlotte roster, really the strength of it is their perimeter play. A good collection of dynamic playmakers and shooters from that point guard to small forward position. They are the bulk of this team's offensive threats.
Orlando trailing here. Outside, Simmons. Payton against Walker. Goes up at the stripe. And the shot no good, a bit short. Greg, the Hornets were strong outside, but weak inside. I guess they've addressed that weakness going for Dwight Howard.
Yeah, they went out and got what they felt could be an anchor on that front line. And Listen, he's going to provide that rim presence that they lacked a season ago. The question is, can he also give them some punch offensively?
Orlando making some changes. Vucevic, he's checked in for Bismack Biyombo. Gordon comes in for Mario Hezonja. And Evan Fournier subbed in for Peyton. So an almost entirely new group in now for Charlotte. Howard's checked in for Frank Kaminsky. Kid Gilchrist comes in for Cody Zeller. Nicholas Batum, he's checked in for Marvin Williams. And Monk's subbed in for Kemba Walker. Batum with the ball, out guarded by Simmons. The Orlando Magic come into this one following a loss to Cleveland. Ross kicks to Fournier. Howard with the steal. Lays it up off the glass. Howard's got six.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Now here's Fournier. He's covered closely. Ross in the corner. Lock at six. Jumper off the screen. The shot, no good. Some solid defense from Kid Gilchrist. Lamb dishes to Batum. Howard with a screen on Ross. Here's Batum. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Now it's a six-point Hornets lead.
And you can't give Batum room to fire off that screen. He'll torture you every time for making that mistake.
Picked by Vucevic. It's Fournier on the wing. It's stolen by Lamb. Pass to Monk. It's stolen by Vucevic. And oh, here we go with Ross. Nobody back. And the jam by Ross.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Well, guys, if you're the other team, you now have to find a way to answer back. Can't afford to give up too much momentum.
Ken Ross with the slam.
Oh, he got fancy with that one.
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open. Now, here's Batum. Screened by Howard. Batum with the ball. And it's Gordon picking him up. Here's Howard. Count it from 12. 8 points for him.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Kicks it to Ross. Simmons sets a screen for Ross. The shot will not fall. And Charlotte will come the other way. And Batum kicks to Lamb. Passes it to Howard. And stolen by Simmons. He kicks it to Gordon. Fournier passes to Vucevic. Excellent D from Howell. Charlotte leading by four. Here's Monk. And that comes off the assist by Dwight Howard. 11 points for Malik Monk.
And how about Monk there? You better get in front of him when he's in attack mode. If you allow him to get to that launching pad, it is too little, too late.
Now here's Vucevic. Just five on the clock. And that one drops for him. Vucevic has got six.
And despite the hot start from beyond, they've gotten away from shooting the triple.
And just a year ago, it seemed that things were set in place for Howard, playing for his hometown team. But in a surprise trade, he was moved out to Charlotte.
And there seems to be a lot of reasons for the trade. I mean, Howard wasn't the right fit in Atlanta. A team trying to get smaller and younger. Never easy to get traded from your hometown team.
Charlotte shooting 40% since the beginning of the second quarter. 52 seconds left in the first half of the game. Howard with a screen on Fournier. Orlando grabs the miss. Vucevic has got 7 rebounds in the game. Ross against Batum. Vucevic dishes to Simmons. Picked by Vucevic. And Simmons kicks to Fournier. Now the feed to Ross. 6 to shoot. Here's Gordon. After two misses to start the game, he's on the board with that shot made.
He lives for these type of battles on the boards. It doesn't matter which end of the floor it is either.
Now here's Lamb. There's the screen. This is DeMonk. Lets it go with a three. That one, no good. And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far. Magic lead by one. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Elford, how big is defense going to be in the second half to help you get this win?
It's going to be big. That's what it's going to come down to. Defense wins games.
It certainly does, Elford. Thank you. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the third quarter.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And welcome to halftime. Hey, what a fantastic time of the year. NBA season getting underway.
I'm excited. I am really, really excited, honey.
It was a closely contested first quarter for Orlando. They were able to squeeze ahead by the end of the period with just a one-point lead. The second quarter was dead even in terms of their scoring output from both teams, and they still find themselves in a good position at the half. What did you think, Kenny, about what we saw from the Magic?
Well, I think they're feeling the energy of this hometown crowd. Sometimes you get a little complacent and comfortable in your surroundings, but no, they fed off adrenaline in the first half.
Shaq, let's get your insight on Charlotte.
You know, they haven't shot the ball very well. Not nearly enough quality looks. Right now, this game could easily come down to shot selection and how they run their offense. They need to keep the ball moving and generate better looks.
That's it for now, as the second half's just about ready to go.
Welcome back, folks. The downtown skyline of Orlando, Florida, looking especially striking tonight. We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. Charlotte trailing. Payton and Fournier are the one and the two. The big men are Gordon and Vucevic, and it's Isaac in at the three. That's who's out there for Orlando. And Kid Gilchrist kicks to Walker. Five on the clock. Got it from 16 feet. Walker's got the first basket of the third quarter for the Hornets.
And as good as Walker is for mid-range, that's the shots you want him taking if you're the D. No threes, no layups.
Here's Gordon. Batum grabs the miss.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Now here's Batum, and stolen by Payton. And here comes the break. Here's Fournier, and a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Fournier's got seven. This game has a lot of character here in the third period. Six changes of the lead here.
Intensity is the theme for this one.
Here's Walker. The shot, no good. And it's the Magic taking it the other way. They'll be playing host to Miami for the next game. That game will conclude a three-game homestand. A tight game here in Orlando. Batum passes to Walker. Too long in the paint, and he's hit with a three-second violation. For Charlotte, they have shot just one free throw, missing that one earlier. And so he hits the technical free throw.
And for the Magic, it's really been a musical chairs with their coaches. A lot of churning on the roster, but the pieces still have yet to gel. And honestly, it's been a mess.
Now, here's Monk. He's got 11. Walker dishes to Kidd Gilchrist. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. And if you're running the Magic, Greg, what's the roadmap to contention?
Well, first and foremost, it's always going to have to start through the draft. You've got to be able to get core pieces there. And then you want to continue to add perimeter shooting and focus on developing your young talent based on the way the game is played today.
Free throw drops for Kidd Gilchrist. And Chris, you were the number one overall draft pick back in 1993. We've seen a lot of greats taken with that pick, but it also seems that those number one picks who aren't as successful face a lot of pressure, a lot of criticism. There's a lot on your plate to handle. Can you talk about that for us?
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure for some players being the number one pick. But I've always laughed and I've thought about, you know, players that maybe people say, maybe they were a bust, maybe this player wasn't good. Well, I think you should go back and look at the GM that picked them. I mean, the GM is the guy that assesses talent, you know. So when there were a few players that were picked number one, and many players said, what are you doing? We've played against him. We would never pick him number one. So before that, I think the NBA is about opportunity and situation. Look at a guy like Chauncey Billups. He went to Boston. He didn't do well at Boston. They called him a malcontent, said he couldn't play, and then he ended up being one of the best leaders that the game had. And so this game is all about situation and opportunity. Can you find the right fit? That's why if you're a player, you can't let frustration get to you. You have to continue to work hard, continue to prove your game, because when you play, you're auditioning for the other teams in the league as well. They're saying, wait a minute, we see his unique talent skills, and we see his unique skill set, and we could use him. And so many times you just have to wait for the right position, the right situation.
Pick by Vucevic. And here's Fournier. He has seven. Just five on the clock. The Magic again can't hit. Charlotte leading by five. In the corner, it's Monk. Kept alive. Batum. And he lays it straight in. Batum's got five.
This is not the same defensive team we saw in the first half. They are giving up way too many open looks.
Payton kicks to Vucevic. It's Fournier on the wing. Payton outside. Picked by Vucevic. Back to Fournier. That's good. And it's Payton with the assist. 10 points for him.
And no fight left in the defense there after a teeth-rattling pick.
Screen by Howard. Upside, Batum. Howard with a screen on Payton. Off the pick. A second chance effort, and Howard with the lay-in. And the Hornets lead by six.
And you need an army to keep Howard away from the basket. He's so superb at snatching up offensive rebounds.
Pass to Isaac. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's on Nicholas Batum.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
The Magic shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight.
Take a break. Two shots.
That's good from Isaac. Like, it's been a long rebuild for the Magic, but they really feel they've got a plan in place.
Well, you've heard the front office talking that they're going to win at least one championship by the year 2030. And I got to say, that's an interesting quote, to say the least. I mean, I have heard of a 5-year plan, but a 13-year plan? I guess you'd call that building for the long term.
And so he makes both from the line. And with sponsors coming to NBA jerseys this season, Hornets fans have to be pleased with their initial sponsor. Makes perfect sense when an owner also owns a shoe brand.
Well, yeah, and Brand Jordan as the owner sponsor just made too much sense. You like how seamless and unobtrusive it's been. If you have to have a jersey sponsor, you can do a lot worse than the Hornets.
And it's the Magic with the ball, following the miss by Kemba Walker. Here's Biombo. Banked in off the glass. Biombo's got his first points of the game.
Now look at that. That's just a great all-around play. Getting into position for the offensive rebound. Finishing strong on the putback.
Zeller passes to Walker. And Kemba Walker is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul.
And really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
Orlando's gone 1-of-4 in three-point shots here in the third. Pass to Isaac. Here's Azania. Payton outside to the middle. Here's Gordon. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton. Payton's got three assists now in this one.
They didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Now here's Batum. 5 points in the game. He feeds it to Zeller. Now the pass to Walker. Back to Zeller. Williams for three. It's rebounded by Payton. Payton's got three rebounds now in this one. To the wing on the left. Here's Azania. And the go-ahead bucket, no good. For Charlotte, they've gone 4 of 9 from the floor so far in the third. Got that one up quick. And that's now 10 points for Kemba Walker.
You can tell he's getting a feel for his shot in the second half.
Gordon with the screen for Payton. At the elbow, it's Gordon. Over Kaminsky. And the foul called on Bismack Biyombo. That'll be his second foul of the game.
He's not the only one to blame for them being behind, but he hasn't helped their cause much.
Charlotte leading by three. Walker dishes to Williams. Pass to Zeller.
Yeah, Walker.
Outside, Batum. And Zeller kicks to Williams. There's a screen by Williams. And here's Walker outside. Walker missing again. And for the Magic, they're shooting 31% here in the third. Offensively, they are looking bleak. Payton with the ball. He's picked up by Walker. Gordon with a screen on Walker. For three, hits it from three-point range. Isaac's got the game tied up here for the Magic.
He is a dangerous outside shooter. And if you leave him open, he can bury them consistently.
Nobody near Williams. Misses off the right iron.
He's got to find better looks, or he's never going to pull out that funk he's in tonight.
Here's Gordon, and there's the bucket. Staying with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. Gordon's got 4 points this quarter.
You can never have enough offense in the low post.
Zeller passes to Walker. And Zeller kicks to Williams. Charlotte moving it around. Picked by Williams. Now the dish to Batum. From the arc. And Williams gets it to go on the assist by Batum. And it's 8 points for Williams.
Well, it's all about a rhythm for a player like Williams. He's effective at shooting right off the pass.
Here's Gordon. Lays it up and banks it in. And the Magic lead by one.
And you can just see he's a different player since coming back from halftime.
Over in the corner, Williams. And it's the Hornets, another three.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Here's Azania. Gordon with a screen on Batum. Feeds it to Gordon. Passes to Azania. A three ball. And that one is off. Charlotte's got more than a 50% success rate on their three-pointers since halftime. They're 4 of 7. Williams kicks to Walker. Williams sets a screen for Walker. And it's Orlando with the rebound. Isaac's got his third rebound on the night. Hezonja kicks to Biyombo. Gordon inside. Kaminsky's there. And the basket by Gordon. Gordon's got 10.
I love watching Isaac find the open teammate. Has great floor awareness out there and just knows when one of his guys has a clean look.
Again, the miss by Williams.
Yeah, that's just poor decision-making. He's got to be better in those situations.
Well, I'd love to hear his explanation of coach right there. I mean, that should be an interesting conversation.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there.
Sure. And Elfrid Payton, the 10th pick back in that 2014 draft. And remember, the Magic looked at him as their point guard of the future. And last season, at times, he was coming off the bench. And it's been about that lack of progress as a shooter that I think is the biggest concern with this team.
Now, here's Walker, following the miss by Aaron Gordon. Zeller, a screen on Payton. And Walker kicks to Zeller. Pick by Zeller. Now the feed to Batum. The three-pointer no good. And for Elfrid Payton, shooting has always been his Achilles heel.
Yeah, as a defender, passer, penetrator, I think he's solid. But shooting has become so important in our league right now. He needs that perimeter shot to really have a chance to get to the next level. And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
Pick by Williams. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
Well, look, it's easy to see how important Kemba Walker is to this offense. His ability to score, but his impact goes beyond that. He does a great job of creating movement and opening up lanes for his teammates. He facilitates without turning over the ball.
First one falls for him. And with Kemba Walker, the Hornets are always one of the better teams in terms of limiting turnovers, and how he is able to take care of the ball is a huge part of that.
Well, fans often overlook how important it is to have a point guard who doesn't give away possessions. Walker is mostly a scoring point guard, but has become an all-around star with the completeness of his game.
That one is no good.
And Kemba Walker, a national champion at UConn, you knew he'd be an impact player in the NBA.
And Fournier gets to Biombo. And yes, it's good. Biombo's got his second bucket of the night.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now here's Kidd Gilchrist. He dishes it to Lamb. There's the pick. Zeller passes to Walker. Kicks it to Lamb. Puts up a three. And that's out of bounds. Charlotte will retain possession.
All right, a chance to look at the numbers now for Walker. Last season, he played outstanding. Last season, put up about 23 points per, 5 assists and 4 rebounds. And he's been putting up points with regularity. I mean, that's what they depend on, his killer instinct on offense.
Yeah, anytime this club needs a basket, he's their go-to guy. Just an irrepressible, prolific scorer.
With one on the clock, Orlando grabs the miss. Biombo's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Ross. It's good, only a few seconds into the shot clock. Now it's a 6-point Orlando lead.
They lean on him for a big portion of their scoring, with a good reason.
And Kidd Gilchrist picks to Walker. 26 seconds left to play here in the third. Here's Kaminsky, and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. That one on Vucevic. Charlotte shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here.
And a season ago at the charity stripe, this is a group that shot an impressive 81%.
The free throw drops for Kaminsky.
Look, he's one of those rare bigs who can score from anywhere.
Kaminsky hasn't been as good of a free throw shooter as one might expect.
Catching up on the changes for Charlotte. Howard comes in for Cody Zeller, and Monks subbed in for Kemba Walker. That one falls, so he hits both of them.
Yeah, I like that they haven't lost their aggressiveness here in the second, despite being down.
Outside, Simmons. He kicks to Biombo. Dishes to Vucevic. Over Howard. Can't hit from 12. And we've reached the end of the third. Magic out in front, up 4. 2K Sports, back in a moment from the Amway Center. And now let's take a listen on head coach Steve Clifford.
Well, we're doing well. Great job. Show your hands. Show your hands. Don't foul.
Moments ago, Steve Clifford talking about defensive technique. Doesn't want to give up free points at the charity line.
And by focusing in on the smallest thing, his guys know how serious he is. One of the better defensive coaches in our league.
All right, the fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. And on the court for Charlotte as we start the fourth. Kaminsky and Howard, the tall front line. Monk is out there with Jeremy Lamb, and it's Kidd Gilchrist in at the three slot. Now here's Kidd Gilchrist. Pass to Howard. He feeds it to Kaminsky. Charlotte moving it around. Kidd Gilchrist, no luck. Magic leading by 4. Kidd Gilchrist with the steal. And here we go. Fast break. Kidd Gilchrist has got it. And slam dunk by Kidd Gilchrist.
And Kidd Gilchrist looking determined to tackle any space in front of him. A sensational finisher in the fast break.
And that replay brought to us by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. One of the more exciting plays in basketball. Now here's Simmons. And it's sent back by Howard. Here's Monk. Here's Kaminsky. And it's all evened up. That gives him the double-double. 11 points and 11 rebounds.
Such an advantage for Kaminsky. He can finish inside with either hand.
Picked by Vucevic. And Simmons kicks to Fournier. From the baseline. And the shot is long.
We'll give him that shot again. He'll probably hit it. That's a good look.
Here's Kaminsky. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. And the Hornets lead by 2.
Well, he's reason number 1 there in front. I mean, his shooting has been almost flawless.
Here's Vucevic. Got it. Good job in the low post. And so here's Charlotte. A great fourth quarter. Just giving up 2 points. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Detroit, where they'll face the Pistons. That'll be the second of this 2-game road trip. Kaminsky. Again, the Hornets score.
Soft touch on the mid-range jumper. Kaminsky taking what the defense gives.
Al Fournier. The pass to Simmons. Now, here's Fournier. He's guarded closely. The Hornets pull it in.
They came close there to tying it up.
Ah, you just hate to miss out on those kinds of opportunities, especially coming down the stretch.
Now here's Kaminsky. Lamb with the ball. 5 on the clock, and stolen by Simmons. And Simmons slams it in.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Well, guys, if you're the other team, you now have to find a way to answer back. Can't afford to give up too much momentum.
Here is Howard following the bucket by Orlando. Outside, Simmons. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Now here's Fournier. Tight defense on him. And Evan Fournier out of France, an instinctive offensive player, Greg.
Yeah, favorite player growing up was Manu Ginobili, and you can see some similarities in their games. Fournier possesses long-range shooting, but also able to handle and put pressure on the D with the dribble.
Now, gentlemen, two shots, loose shots.
And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. Peyton, he's checked in for Orlando. Nicholas Batum, he's checked in for Charlotte. Kemba Walker comes in for Jeremy Lamb. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Howard with a screen on Ross. They set the pick. Monk kicks to Kidd Gilchrist. Pass to Batum. Rocket six. The dish to Monk. There's Walker with the three. Vucevic with the rebound. Vucevic has got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. For three, Fournier. It's rebounded by Charlotte. Kidd Gilchrist has got his fifth rebound in this one. And stolen by Fournier. And they're on the break. Feeds to Peyton. Now, here's Biombo. Pass to Ross. Launches a three. It's rebounded by Kidd Gilchrist. Kidd Gilchrist has got six rebounds now in the game. A shot by Batum, no good. Ross with it, and Batum picks him up defensively. Ross kicks to Peyton. It's stolen by Monk. Batum against Fournier. Outside, Batum. Walker dishes to Kidd Gilchrist. Misses, and the dry spell continues.
You can see he just rushed that a little bit. Lost the focus, I think.
Well, he doesn't look like himself right now. Nothing is going his way.
Walker against Peyton. Walker goes in. And they're unable to get the tying basket there. Fast break. Here come the Magic. Looking to get it going. Batum grabs the miss.
And so far this quarter, he's been a little off on his game.
Yeah, the scoring, I mean, it's not coming easy for him. You have to get into a little rhythm, but that's when you can make the extra pass. Play the role of the facilitator.
Now here's Walker. Howard with a screen on Peyton. Left side, Kidd Gilchrist. Just five to shoot. Here's Monk. And it comes off the front of the rim.
Not easy to miss a clean look inside like that, but he manages to do it.
Ross, that's good.
Love the tenacity. That's money in tight against the pressure.
Hornets trail by four. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
And it's Walker penetrating. Using his post moves to get the 2 points. Walker's got 11 points here in just the second half.
Oh, Walker is a confident player. Never bashful at going to work down inside.
Peyton kicks to Vucevic. There's the feed to Fournier. No good on the triple.
Now he should heavily consider looking to his teammates as the game gets close. His shot just isn't falling.
Here's Monk. And it's off the back rim. No good.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Now here's Fournier. He's guarded closer. Kicks to Ross. Picked by Vucevic. Batum with the steal. Only one man back on D to tie it up. He takes it up and lays it in. Batum's got it all tied up now for Charlotte.
And the long legs of Batum, that's what allows him to leak out so quickly in transition. He runs the floor like a jaguar.
Payton gets to Vucevic. He dishes it to Fournier. Kept alive Orlando. The shot by Payton, no good. Charlotte has gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Here's Walker. Kid Gilchrist, a screen on Payton. They set the screen, so they take the lead. And the Hornets lead by two.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
He kicks it to Ross. Dishes it to Fournier. At the elbow, Vucevic over Howard. That one wide left. For Charlotte, they've gone 7-16 from the field here in the fourth. That's about 43%. Up again. It's hauled in by the Magic.
It's been a rough game for him, but it won't sting too bad as long as they hang on to the lead.
Payton passes to Fournier. And he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick. Fournier's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Just an ugly fourth quarter, 1 of 8 from the field.
Howard setting the pick for Walker. Pass to Howard. Shoots over Vucevic. And the shot no good, a bit short.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Ross in the corner, beyond the arc. Monk grabs the board. Hornets shooting around 37% in the fourth quarter. The minutes starting to wear on them. Walker against Payton. From 10 feet out, Walker's shot is off. And for the Magic, they're shooting a meager 37% for the game. Here's Fournier, and a little luck that time, but it drops.
Nightmarish fourth quarter, just 2 of 9 shooting anybody's game, and that's one reason why.
Here's Walker. He's at the pick. He feeds it to Monk. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Kid Gilchrist. They get the rebound. And Howard with the second chance points.
And you know Howard wants that responsibility offensively, and that time he comes through for his team.
Time call here. The Magic decide to talk it over.
Just hitting the reset button, a chance to kind of talk some things over.
And the chance to draw up a great play. I mean, this is a chess match at work.
And now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Dwight Howard.
And he's put on a terrific show of skill in the paint. A combination of moves, footwork, and that soft touch down low. It's all added up to one dominant performance for the big fella.
Gordon's checked in for the Magic. Isaac comes in for Ross. And a switcher also for Charlotte. Cody Zeller's checked in for Dwight Howard. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
During that break, Frank Vogel had some real words for his team. And he's pushing them to empty the tank. He said, "I know you're tired and it's been a tough game, but you can't hold back. If you're tired, come out. Otherwise, I want you full speed." Guys.
It's stolen by Monk. And oh, here we go. Batum's got it. Galloping the fast break chance with the tip. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. And it's 6 points for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist.
That's a big-time player right there. Kidd-Gilchrist showing what he's made of.
Gordon kicks to Fournier. There's 1:17 left here in the fourth quarter. Magic moving the ball around. He climbs that one off the back iron, and down it falls. Fournier's got the game tied up here for the Magic. Charlotte's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Now Monk, picked by Zeller. And it's Walker penetrating. No good that time. Good D by Peyton. And Orlando has possession. The pass to Gordon. Here's the screen. Here's Vucevic. It's rebounded by Kidd-Gilchrist.
Almost every look he gets inside is a good one, but the D hangs in there and makes it a tough one.
Now, that is cold-blooded.
Well, we want people to tune in, don't we? This is what they're tuning in to. Big moments.
Now a timeout called by Orlando. They're behind by two. 29 seconds left in the game. Seconds left in the fourth quarter. There's a screen. Here's Vucevic. Oh, wow, a huge basket to tie the game. That gives him the double-double. 10 points and 14 rebounds. Charlotte calls timeout. Walker dishes to Monk. Back to Walker. Over Peyton. Can't cash in.
He is such a focused, intense competitor. Zeller rising to the challenge at the biggest moments.
And so it's the Hornets who come out on top. This win, such a tremendous emotional boost for him.
Really an accomplishment and crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire building.
And that'll do it for the first game of the NBA season. For Greg Anthony, Chris Webber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. So long, everyone.